How long does it take to launch a spacecraft from Florida? Perhaps we can make a prediction based on the progress we've seen at the Cape, and what we've seen at Boca Chica, that the spacecraft factory at the Cape over the Boca Chica is developing at lightning speed. Join us as we bring you, SpaceX new orbital launch site is soon ready to launch Starship from Florida. You don't need 4 turrets and a 39A turret to launch an almost finished spaceship, while SLS is still on the runway. We're seeing great progress in 39A, how Florida spaceship factories are Starbase factory buildings, remember what they looked like when we last flew them. The speed is obvious. The first part of the building now has a roof, while the outer walls are raised at the same time. At the factory, part of the roof is prefabricated and continues to be fashionably assembled on the assembly line. It looks more and more like a suitable building in Boca Chica. To the east of the factory building, we can see the future development of Mega Bay. One of the smaller site cranes is now in the middle of a building under construction. While a SpaceX LR11000 crane is awaiting major construction, to begin as additional parts are placed nearby. Depending on how long it takes to build the Mega Bay at the Starbase. Mega Bay, for reference, will begin construction at the end of August 2021, and during the year until Mega Bay is fully operational. A series of small foundations are being laid on the front ridge at the entrance to Mega Bay, which is a series of small foundations on one side of each building. Just as high bays and large bays are built on a star base with a foundation, each level is pre-built before being raised and attached to the structure. The advance towards the northern production area continues on the quick-release chopstick arms, wagons and ships, where you can see that there are already rails attached to the chopstick arms themselves. It will be necessary to stow and lift the boosters on the pads as soon as SpaceX can do so. A display holding the shoulder area of the arm is shown. This is the arm closest to the spacecraft launch tower QD arm. The sled system is equipped with hydraulic accumulators to help open and close the trunk, and before the spacecraft leaves Florida, all of these parts must be completed and transported to 39A, and mounted on the tower. Of course, based on the same activity in Boca Chica, you can expect it to take about 4 to 5 months. Above the tower construction site, the last segment of the tower with a lifting system is visible, with a set of self-propelled modular conveyors installed below. This indicates that in the near future, the implementation of overground flights for this segment will certainly be inevitable. After our flight, the last part of the tower, which fell on 39A, may have fallen on top of the tower. Once this happens, the spacecraft launch tower will reach its final height at 39A. The launch complex 39A is, that the spacecraft launch tower is actually 3 floors higher than our last flight, but in this scene we fly. Segment 8 rose in doing so, but as it replaced the Falcon 9's fixed service structure, it was only 2 stories taller. NASA last year picked SpaceX, to use Starship for the agency's first launch of U.S. astronauts to the lunar surface, since the days of the Apollo program. The rocket's next big test, a complex task of launching to orbit for the first time, has been delayed in part by the regulatory review of the Texas Compound's environmental impact, which has precluded the FAA from granting SpaceX its orbital launch license. Set to conclude Monday, the review is expected to place conditions on SpaceX that could add delays to its Starship program. That prospect led Musk to double down last year on construction of Starship's launchpad at 39A, in Florida at Cape Canaveral. We do have the alternative of the Cape, and we actually applied for environmental approval for launch from the Cape a few years ago and received it. Musk said at a Starship update event in February, estimating it would take 6 to 8 months up the Cape launch tower and launch from there. But, the preparations for Starship on the East Coast are continuing to build up, both at the Roberts Road and LC-39A sites. 5 launch tower sections have been constructed at Roberts Road, with segments 1 and 3 having more hardware installed in their floors, such as handrails on the outer perimeter and in the elevator shaft. The elevator shaft is also getting a grating that acts as a safety barrier door. Few months ago, Elon shared a render of how the Roberts Road complex will look once all significant work is done, and this cosmetic work can be seen on that same corner of the Hangar X building. It also shows the opening for vehicles to enter and exit. High Bay 3 will be on the north side, and the Starbase factory will feature 2 different roof heights, likely to accommodate nose cone and payload bay stacking. However, these plans appear to be somewhat fluid from a final design standpoint, with NSF's Harry Stranger spotting updated schematics of the Roberts Road factory plan, which could actually include two high bays. Development of the ground systems required to test and launch the spacecraft at 39A continues as usual. The large cryogenic tank at 39A is now more than double the height when we last flew, and construction has begun on another tank to the north of this new tank. It seems to use a more traditional design due to the location, but I wouldn't do that. I'd be surprised if this is an additional methane tank, but we'll have to wait. Looks like it's on the south side of this tank. The newly upgraded hydrogen, which has recently been converted to a methane balloon, is completely white compared to the last flight and is now shiny. As the repairs progressed, a new set of transport lines was a good sign, stretching south of the methane tank field where the launch site was located. In satellite image 39A, we can see all of this progress from an orbital perspective, and we can see a new supercooler added next to the large cold tank, lending weight to the hypothesis that it is part of the LOX tank spacecraft farm. The blocking balls that SpaceX is currently using on 39A to launch the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy have not worked at all over the last month. It seems that there is another additional facility at the oil depot, similar to the one under construction in Boca Chica. The cryogenic bunkers will house all the key components needed to control and dose the propellant and other products needed for the tower and orbit. Boosters during testing and launch in these two satellite and flight images, we can see strange tubes and other structures added to the octagonal structure of the old spacecraft. Mystery of the past, based on all of the above, I wanted to make it clear that it is a complete speculation. That the launch of the spacecraft in Florida will take place at least a year from now, and the schedule may need to include the ship. Not based on bugs, no, I don't think they will fly boats or boosters with a Boca Chica bow. Used by Boca Chica to control the barge. Too long or too short. Or write us your opinion in the comments. Not all 39A, but Falcon 9 is missing because of the track. Nearby, several supports for GSE lines are also visible to the north of the launch tower, and over at the former Starship landing site by the two tents. Following the utilization of Starbase and 39A, SpaceX will then work on additional options, such as two pads at LC-49 and its two ocean platforms, Phobos and Deimos. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.